Let's go over some theorems about injective linear transformations. These are called one-to-one linear transformations in the book. So recall, a map from Rn to Rm is called injective, or one-to-one. That means is every vector in Rm is the image of at most one vector in Rn. In other words, if T of U1 equals T of U2, then we must have U1 equals U2. So let's take a picture of what an injective linear transformation might look like. So if I have U1 in Rn, it's going to get mapped to T of U1 in Rm. If I have a different point, U2 in Rn, it's going to get mapped to a different point, T of U2 in Rm. This is an injective map. I can have points in Rm that aren't in the image of T, and it's still injective. What forces it not to be injective is if I have some point in Rn and it gets mapped to a point that's already mapped to under T, right? So here I have this blue dot and this red dot getting mapped to the same point in Rn, and so this map is no longer injective. Okay, so let's go through a theorem. Suppose I have a linear transformation from Rn to Rm. Then this map T is injective if and only if T of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution, right? So notice what this is saying. The map being injective talks about how it behaves on the whole domain. So the power of this theorem is it's saying for a linear transformation, it's enough to understand what's going on at zero. So just as an aside, let's recall, if I want to prove a biconditional, an if and only if type of statement, the way I do that is in two parts. So if I want to prove P if and only if Q, I have to prove if P then Q, and then I prove if Q, then P. Okay, so we'll prove this in two steps. First, we're going to assume that T is injective, and we want to show that T of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution. Well, T of the 0 vector is 0 because T is a linear transformation, and T is injective, which means there are no other vectors U other than the 0 vector, such that T of U equals 0. So now let's go the other way. Conversely, suppose T of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution, and we want to show that T is injective. So suppose U1 and U2 are vectors in Rn, such that T of U1 equals T of U2. In order to show that T is injective, we need to show that U1 equals U2. So we compute, right? We're working under the assumption that T of U1 equals T of U2. I can subtract T of U2 from both sides and get T of U1 minus T of U2 equals 0. But T is linear, which means the left-hand side is equal to T of U1 minus U2. But we're assuming that T of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution, which means U1 minus U2 must be the 0 vector. Or in other words, U1 equals U2 as desired. And therefore, T is injective if and only if T of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution. Now let's prove another theorem about injective linear transformations. Suppose I have a linear transformation T from Rn to Rm with standard matrix A. Right, so remember that means that T of x equals A times x. And then T is injective if and only if the columns of A are linearly independent. Let's go through the proof. First, we have to give the columns of A names so that we can deal with them later in the proof. So we'll write A as column vector A1, A2, all the way up to AN. And assume T is injective. then by the previous theorem, t of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution. And if we unwind what that means about the matrix, we're saying that ax equals the 0 vector has only the trivial solution. And so if we write that as a vector equation, that's x1 a1 plus x2 a2 plus all the way up to xn an equals the 0 vector has only the trivial solution. But that's exactly the definition for this collection of vectors a1 up to an to be linearly independent. Now conversely, suppose the columns of A are linearly independent. Then the vector equation x1 a1 plus x2 a2 all the way up to xn an equals 0 has only the trivial solution by definition. But that's exactly t of x, and so this is saying precisely that t of x equals 0 has only the trivial solution. And therefore t is injective if and only if the columns of the standard matrix of t are linearly independent.